Ang sabi ni James Clear, I think about decisions in three ways. Hats, haircuts, and tattoos. Most decisions we make every day are like hats. If you try on a hat and it doesn't suit you, you can simply put it back and try another one. The cost of making a mistake is minimal. The key to handling hat decisions is to be open to experimentation because the more hats you try, the better your chances of finding one that fits perfectly. Don't overanalyze these choices. Embrace the low stakes and the flexibility to change your mind. Pagdating sa personal finance, how does this apply? What are the examples of hat decisions that we make about money? The first one is switching savings accounts. Moving your savings to a different bank account with a slightly higher interest rate. If you find a better option later, you can switch again with minimal hassle. And marami akong kilala na gumagawa nito. Kasama ako, although hindi naman ako sobrang all-in, yung kung merong digital bank, especially na nag-o-offer ng mataas na interest rate, nag-open ako ng account doon to take advantage of that high interest promo rate. So emphasis on the promo. Dahil itong mga promo rates na to, it will usually run for several months, 5 months, up to a year, and then bababa na siya. At that point, I will see if there are other digital banks that can offer better interest rate, and then lipat tayo doon. Especially sa Pilipinas na wala namang consequence kapag lumilipat ka ng banko, pag nag-close ka at nag-open ng accounts. Merong initial na holding period, usually, I don't know, 30 days. If you are already past that threshold and there's really a savings account that with higher interest rate, then just go ahead and switch accounts. Napaka-minimal ng consequences ito. Actually, halos wala nga. And I think it's a hat decision. Kung mag-open ka ng bank account, especially if it's your first one sa mga young urban professionals natin, just open where it is convenient. And then, kung may nahanap kang branch na mas maganda yung customer service, then lipat ka. Another hat decision that we make about money is yung daily spending choices. Deciding whether to buy a coffee every morning or bring one from home. These small daily decisions can be easily adjusted based on your preference and budget constraints. So yung mga gastos natin everyday, minsan may mga temptation tayo. Sabihin natin na gumastos, and alam naman natin na hindi dapat natin ginagawa yung mga impulsive purchases. However, if we do give in to the temptation and decide to buy something unnecessary, which is out of our budget, I think it's easy to let go of that bad decision, move on. It's a hot decision na, okay, mali yung ginawa ko, next time, tama na yung gagawing decision. We can easily correct that the next time. And because these are small impulse purchases, hopefully, konti lang sila, and it will not have a very big impact on our budget. Ang importante kasi dito is nakaka-move on kagad tayo. For example, meron akong kaibigan na sinabi niya na hindi na siya mag-impulse purchase. However, talagang hindi niya na-resist yung temptation, may nakita siyang sale sa mall, napabili siya. And nung ginawa niya yon, sobrang guilty siya, sobrang nainis siya sa sarili niya na it affected yung mga subsequent budgeting days niya na napagastos na ako so useless na yung pagbabudget ko. So mas lalo siya naging magastos bigla. We do give in to temptation once in a while, hopefully once in a while only. And don't let it burden you and just continue with the good money habits that you are doing. Especially kung hot decision or hot mistake lang yung nagawa mo. Another hot decision or minor decision that we do with our money is yung mga small investments. Putting a small amount of money into a new app or service for budgeting or saving, go ahead and try it. If it doesn't work out, the loss is minimal and you can always try another tool. Ang personal experience ko dito yung mga productivity apps. May mga kilala ako allergic do sa mga free trial, mga ganyan, no? Parang gusto nila na kapag may pinili silang app, budgeting man or productivity tool, yun na yung permanent. So, talagang todo research sila kung ano yung pinakamaganda. Para sa akin, I do read reviews, I do accept recommendations, pero hindi ko siya in-overanalyze because yung app naman, kung in-install ko siya, tinry ko siya for a month, hindi ko siya gusto, I can always try another app. I can take off the hat and try another one. So, I do install yung mga apps na may bayad pero may free trial just to see, okay ba to? Worth it ba to kung magbabayad ako? The second type of decision that we have is yung mga haircuts. A bad haircut might make you feel self-conscious for a while, but it will grow out and eventually it won't matter. Haircut decisions have a higher cost and take longer to fix than hat decisions. However, they are still not permanent. Don't be paralyzed by the fear of making a mistake. Trying something new can be a rewarding experience. And even if it doesn't turn out as expected, time has a way of smoothing over these bumps. So medyo may risk na yung haircuts, but most of the consequences, hindi major, and it eventually fixes itself over time. So again, kung yung mga hot decisions, wag na nating i-overanalyze. Yung haircuts naman, it's important to analyze, but it should not paralyze us kasi merong paralysis by analysis eh. So, let's make a good analysis, and even if we don't know all the factors that we should consider, we can definitely make a decision and deal the consequences if there are any later on. Because besides, these consequences are not permanent, or there will always be a way to fix yung mga mistakes later on. Examples of financial decisions that we make na haircut decisions are, number one, setting up an emergency fund. Paano naging haircut decision to? Well, deciding how much to set aside for emergencies, if you realize later that you need more, it will take time to adjust your budget, but it's not impossible. May mga kilala ako na ang emergency fund nila ay 20,000 pesos lang. So, para sa kanila, okay na yon. But when they had a consultation with me, sabihin ko na kulang yung 20,000. So, that was a mistake on their part. However, it's a haircut decision. Sabi ko, that's okay, at least meron ka. You're far better off than other people na walang emergency fund. But the consequences of this is you have to go back to your budget, try to see how you can save more so that you can build your emergency fund higher. So, it's not a permanent mistake na hindi mo makokorek. There will be some adjustments in your life, but eventually, over time, it will smooth out or it will fix itself. It's the same with creating a budget. Managing your monthly budget is always a challenge. Knowing how much to allocate per expense can be confusing, but over time, things will work out, things will smooth itself out. May mga nakakausap kasi ako, gusto nila pa nag-set sila ng budget, ang perfect na kagad. Sabi ko, hindi, kasi yung personal budget ko, ang experience ko, it took me years din eh. 2 to 3 months to get used to the habit of tracking my expenses. A few more months para hindi ako magkamali sa mga computations. And that's just the technical side. Another few months in managing yung allocation ng pera ko. And short to say, it took me years before I really became comfortable with the budgeting strategy that I use. So, hindi siya instant. It takes some time. And along the way, I did make a lot of mistakes. Nung umpisa, iniisip ko, ito lang yung ano ko, i-aalat ko sa entertainment. Okay na to. Kailangan ko kasi magtipid. Kailangan ko mag-invest para sa mga financial goals ko. And then later on, napansin ko na, malaki yung entertainment expenses ko, especially yung mga friends ko na mahilig lumabas. So talagang na gagalaw ko yung pera na naka-allocate sa ibang expense categories. And not until I accepted na mali yung ginawa ko dito sa allocation ko sa entertainment. Kailangan ko siyang taasan or kailangan kong mag-isip ng paraan para i-refuse yung mga invitations ng friends ko na lumabas para bumaba yung gastos ko. So, there were some things that I needed to do to fix yung mistake kasi hindi talaga ako nakapag-save nung umpisa dahil doon sa mga gastos. But eventually, over time, naayos ko din siya and ngayon, masaya ako kung paano ko hinahati yung pera ko sa mga monthly na gastos ko. So, creating a budget, that takes time. Don't be afraid to make a mistake. Yung mga mistakes na mangyayari dyan, hindi naman permanent and as long as you have a stable source of income, then you'll be able to improve, make your process or strategies better. Pagdating sa pag-i-invest natin, yung mga investment returns kasi natin, they are subject to many factors that are beyond our control. But over time, as we become more familiar with the financial markets and different investments, we can refine our strategies to minimize losses. So kung first time mong mag-i-invest or merong kang pera na gustong i-invest, maganda na nagre-research ka, nag-analyze ka, but do not complicate things, do not paralyze yourself from making a decision. So kung ano yung makita mo from the initial na research mo, doon ka na mag-invest, go ahead. Huwag mo nang isipin na, ay nako baka mayroong mas magandang investment or baka mali yung analysis ko, hindi maganda yung maging performance itong investment na to. Okay lang yan, go ahead, invest ka lang. Kasi over time, you can always rebalance your portfolio, reallocate your assets, your money, and whatever investing mistake that you did, kung long term naman ang pag-uusapan natin, it will eventually smooth itself out. Yung mga gains, it will definitely overtake the losses that you experienced in the past. Pagdating sa investing decisions, go ahead and go for what makes sense at the moment. Don't be too hard on yourself. Don't be paralyzed with fear na baka mali itong pinipili ko. Kasi, especially sa mga mutual funds, UITF, napakadaling i-rebalance yan, i-reallocate, madaling i-redeem tapos ilipat sa iba. Ang importante, nag-i-invest ka ngayon. And over time, you'll be more educated about the performances of different investments and you'll be able to make better decisions about your investment portfolio. The last type of decision that we make ay yung mga tattoos. And syempre, these are the permanent ones. And finally, some decisions are like tattoos. These are the choices that leave a permanent mark. Once made, they are difficult, if not impossible, to reverse. The stakes are high and the consequences are long-lasting. It's crucial to move slowly and think carefully when making these decisions. Unlike hats or haircuts, a tattoo decision is something you will carry with you for years, if not forever. So make sure it's a decision you can live with as it will become a part of your identity. I consider buying a home, property, a tattoo decision because it's a long-term payment plan. Committing to a mortgage is a long-term financial decision with significant consequences. It's not easy to reverse if you realize later that it was a mistake. If you're buying a property to use as a rental property, then you should have a business plan. But still, it's a carefully prepared plan to see kung ano yung profitability niya. But if you're buying a residential home, usually, mas nagigive in tayo dun sa emotion na, ay, ang ganda ng lugar, ang ganda ng bahay, gusto ko yung location, malapit sa school, para sa mga anak ko, etc. So, mas emotional yung decision pag bahay. That's why you should remind yourself to sit down, really run through the numbers because it's a tattoo decision. It might not be a permanent as in permanent decision, but it will be hard to reverse once you purchase and start paying for that mortgage. Another tattoo decision is yung retirement plan choices natin. Choosing a retirement lifestyle and preparing for it requires long-term investment decisions. Changing your plan years later can be very difficult. Pag may nagpapakonsult sa akin, isa talaga yan sa mga kinukulit ko sa kanila na ang sabi mo, magre-retire ka dito lang sa Pilipinas. Are you really sure about that? Kasi yung kamag-anak mo nasa abroad, tapos wala ka ng kamag-anak sa probinsya, etc. So I really remind them na once you imagine yourself na ganito yung gusto kong retirement and you start investing for that retirement lifestyle, years down the line, it would be difficult to change strategies kung mag-iba yung plano mo. Of course, you cannot really predict the future, but at the very least, you are really convinced na yun yung gusto mo. May mga nagdadalawang isip kasi na hindi alam kung basta magre-retire ako, gusto ko lang mag-invest for my retirement. So pag ganun, very generic din yung magiging investment strategy, which I think is okay because you're still in the process of studying it. But kung talagang convinced ka na, hindi, ang retirement ko, magre-retire ako sa probinsya, magpa-farm na lang ako, mag-aalaga ako ng mga hayop, magtatanim ng mga gulay. Kung ganun ka-specific yung retirement plan mo, then it's actually better because we can design an investment strategy to be able to reach that kind of lifestyle when you retire. If you're still young, it's good to have a general idea what you want to do when you retire. You can invest kung ano man yung magandang investment at that point. Total, nabanggit naman natin ang pag-i-invest, it's a haircut decision. However, dahil ang dami mong investment decisions na gagawin, pag pinagsama-sama mo yan, it can become a tattoo decision kapag yung overall design ng portfolio mo ay mali and it will not really help you achieve yung retirement lifestyle na gusto mo. The point here is take the time to really imagine, decide kung ano bang gusto mo pagdating sa retirement. And similarly, dun sa pagbili ng bahay, yung pagtatayo ng negosyo. Investing a significant amount of your savings into starting a business is a tattoo decision. If the business fails, you might lose most or all of your investment, which can have long-lasting financial repercussions. Nako, lalong-lalo na kapag inipon mo ng maraming taon yung kapital para sa negosyo mo tapos hindi naman nag-succeed yung business mo, then meron din siyang emotional repercussions, hindi lang financial repercussions. That's why when I'm advising someone pagdating sa entrepreneurship, my first tip is to do a smaller scale version of the business. Kung gusto mo mag-restaurant, medyo mag-catering ka muna or try to put up a small eatery first before ka mag-full-blown na restaurant. Kung gusto mo mag franchise, then take the time to really study yung mga branches, mag-observe, mag-research, kasi once na maglabas ka na ng pera for the franchise fee, committed ka na dyan for at least 3 to 5 years. So, may pagka-sense of permanence or long-term yung consequences ng decisions mo. So, take the time to really study and dito, pwede kang mag-overanalyze but not to the point na mapaparalyze ka. Of course, it's better to always make a decision in the end. But hopefully, it's a calculated decision na well-researched and coming from a well-informed place ka. For life, including financial decisions, remembering to understand the nature of the decision at hand can help you approach it with the appropriate mindset. For hard decisions, prioritize speed and flexibility. For haircut decisions, be open to taking risks but remain mindful of the recovery period. For tattoo decisions, proceed with caution and deliberate thoroughly. Use your experiences to refine your decision-making process. Learn from the hats that didn't fit, the haircuts that needed time to grow out, and the tattoos that you live with. Each type of decision offers valuable lessons.